Heyo everyone! Last week, Xbox had their biggest leak of all time, and now that the dust has settled, I wanted to talk about some of the biggest revelations from the leak. Over the past year, Xbox has been under investigation from the FTC on their bid for Activision Blizzard. Part of the investigation included confidential Xbox documents from April of 2022, which is where these leaks are coming from. Even though the FTC is the group suing Activision, they made it abundantly clear that they are not taking the blame for this leak. Apparently, Microsoft incorrectly uploaded the investigation files to the court website, leading to basically the floodgates opening up since the website is accessible to the public. The FTC quickly removed the files, but the damage has already been done, so today I wanted to go over some of the craziness that was revealed last week. As I mentioned before, these documents were dated back to April of 2022 and earlier, so some of these leaks might still hold up, while others may have just been concepts that got delayed or canceled entirely. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Alright, let's get it. Alright, so at number 10, let's talk about Bethesda's upcoming titles. Starfield has finally released and will probably have some DLC in the future, but the main focus for Bethesda now should be on The Elder Scrolls 6. Way back in 2018, we got a teaser trailer for The Elder Scrolls 6, but haven't heard much since, other than they are working on it. Well, one of the leaks indicates that the earliest we could see a new Elder Scrolls game could be 2026, basically just 2 years away. I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I don't think it's going to hit that release window. With how big video games are these days and the massive amount of work and time that goes into development, I just don't really see a 2026 release date. I have a theory on when the game might come out, but I'm going to save that for my last point in the video. Probably the most significant tidbit from this roadmap, however, is that it seemingly confirms that The Elder Scrolls 6 will be Xbox and PC exclusive. I suppose this is to be expected at this point. Skyrim is one of the best-selling games of all time, so I thought there was a chance that Microsoft would try and capitalize on that name value by opening up the game to cross-platform releases, but it looks like they want to make this one an exclusive and get more people on their platform. It makes sense. I mean, you don't spend $7.5 billion just to share these coveted games with your competitors. So does this mean that every Bethesda game moving forward will be Xbox PC exclusive? We knew that Starfield was going to be because it was a new IP, and Phil Spencer, head of Xbox, mentioned that any other new IPs would also be an exclusive. Well, one of the leaked documents revealed that Phil Spencer has made up his mind and that going forward, all ZeniMax games will be exclusive. That means any new installments of Fallout, Doom, Wolfenstein, and more will be Xbox PC exclusive. It seems like Phil is going all in on using Bethesda to try and get more Xbox users. I guess we'll see how it plays out. Let's move on. At number 9, we found out that Activision got a look behind the curtain for the Switch 2, or whatever Nintendo's next console is. The rumors of the Switch 2 have been heating up the past few weeks, and the leaks indicate that Nintendo is shooting for a 2024 release. The Xbox documents kinda indicate that that might be true. It looks like Activision was given the Switch 2 specs in December of 2022, probably so they could begin development for any games they would like to launch on the new console. Not a whole lot was revealed from this interaction, but it should be noted that the Switch 2's predicted performance capabilities is closer to that of the PS4 and Xbox One than it is with the PS5 and Xbox Series. So do with that information what you will. Number 8 is kind of a doozy. We got a first look at a ton of new Xbox hardware, including a mid-gen refresh with a brand new controller. We've had rumblings of a PS5 mid-gen refresh for a few months now, and in response, Phil Spencer actually stated that the Xbox Series didn't need a refresh. Well, the leaks say otherwise. It seems as if Xbox is planning a mid-gen refresh for holiday 2024, which makes sense. It's been 4 years since the Xbox Series and PS5 released. Oh my god, it's been 4 years? Jesus, we're old. So, here is the new Xbox Series X, codenamed Brooklyn in a weird spelling. Like the Series X, this console will be the powerhouse that targets 4K 60 FPS, but this time, it will be more energy efficient and have some upgraded Wi-Fi capabilities to reduce lag. Like the Series S, this console will be digital only, or, as Microsoft has stated it, adorably all digital. Gross. There will also be 2 TB internal storage, good, a new USB-C front port, cool, and, surprisingly, the same price of $499. Nice. Weirdest thing, obviously, is that this thing is shaped like a cylinder and looks really freaking weird. I do not like the look of this at all. Gives me the eebie-jeebies. There will also be a refreshed Series S launching a good 2 months before Brooklyn does to give it its own time in the spotlight, according to the leaks. Doesn't look like too much is changing for this one. They're improving the energy performance and adding in the new Wi-Fi that I mentioned earlier, and also adding in a front USB-C port. Same price as well, which is honestly a steal for 9th gen gaming. Okay, but let's talk about this new Xbox controller. Codenamed Sebile, this bad boy looks like it's taking a page out of Sony's playbook by implementing new haptic feedback, speakers, and even an accelerometer. Thankfully, this controller will finally have rechargeable batteries included. It's also going to have modular thumbsticks so you can swap them out if you'd like, which is a pretty sweet upgrade. Probably the biggest thing I noticed was that it has a lift to wake feature. I'm not really sure how that's gonna work out in the end, but I think it's interesting. There also seems to be an emphasis on how accessible this controller will be for different platforms, including a specific direct-to-cloud option. Xbox really seems to be going in on this cloud gaming stuff, huh? At number 7, we got some hints at upcoming remasters. One of the documents mentioned that Bethesda was working on remasters for The Elder Scrolls IV, Oblivion, and Fallout 3. However, this document is one of the older ones, dating back 3 years ago, before Microsoft even closed the deal on ZeniMax. So, we don't know for sure if those plans got cancelled or if there's still a possibility of them releasing sometime in the future. The original timeline had Oblivion and Indiana Jones releasing in 2022, while the Fallout 3 remaster was slated to launch in 2024 with The Elder Scrolls 6 and a few other titles. Obviously, this hasn't happened and probably won't happen with these dates, but that doesn't mean that those plans were thrown out. We could still be seeing these releases in the near future. Another big game that was mentioned to have a next-gen update was Red Dead Redemption 2. It seems as if Xbox wanted to launch it on Game Pass in the winter of 2022, but that time is coming past and we haven't heard anything, so I don't know if there's any sort of update heading our way, which is a bummer because that game is incredible and definitely deserves some more love. Moving on to number 6, speaking of Game Pass, it looks like Baldur's Gate 3 might be coming to the service? There was an email thread where Xbox was searching for potential 2022-23 Game Pass launches for their lineup and considered Baldur's Gate 3, but ultimately turned it down, calling it a second-run Stadia PC RPG. Sheesh, what a misstep by Microsoft. Baldur's Gate 3 is one of the best games to release this year, and a year filled with some heavy hitters. Xbox can't take all the blame though, because even the Larian Studios director himself mentioned that everyone else had a similar stance. Hopefully Xbox can work something out and get Baldur's Gate 3 on Game Pass when it launches on the platform. Otherwise, you had your chance, Xbox. Moving down to number 5, the Xbox Series S is a powerhouse in sales. According to an April 2022 report, 75% of Xbox Series owners have the Series S. What? That is insane! I guess the more enthusiastic gamers have gravitated towards the powerful Series X, while more casual gamers have opted in for the Series S. The Series S has been in some debate recently for its lack of power and Xbox's feature parity requirement. If you didn't know, Baldur's Gate 3 has launched on PC and PlayStation, but hasn't launched on Xbox yet because Microsoft is requiring Larian Studios to include all features for the Series X version and the Series S version, particularly the split-screen mode. Xbox has since backtracked a bit and said that the Series S doesn't have to support split-screen, but it still brings up the good point of the small console being a bit underpowered. That being said, I guess it doesn't really matter. People are loving this little machine, so don't expect it to go away anytime soon. At number 4, Phil Spencer wanted to buy Nintendo. This one has been out there in the rumor mill for a while, but this leak seemingly confirms it. Before Microsoft decided on Activision Blizzard, they were considering around 100 different developers, including big names like Sega, Square Enix, Zynga, Valve, and even Warner Bros. Interactive. It's kind of crazy. For some of these developers, like Zynga, Phil Spencer argued against buying them because he didn't believe that they had enough to offer for what Microsoft was looking for. These guys are the devs behind Farmville, so it should be clear that Xbox was looking to go big or go home. Which brings us to Nintendo. According to an old email dated from August 2020, Phil Spencer really wanted to buy Nintendo. Obviously, that didn't happen, but could you imagine Zelda and Mario on an Xbox console? Or Game Pass coming to the Switch? I can't even fathom that. I think Xbox buying Activision is a bit more palatable because they're mostly just a video game developer slash publisher, whereas Nintendo does that and makes consoles. Truthfully, I'm glad that this one didn't work out. I mean, the Nintendo fanboy in me wants Nintendo to do their own thing forever, but the Xbox fanboy part of me would have really loved to see what Microsoft could do with expanding Game Pass and giving Nintendo some actually decent online services. Moving on to number 3, we can see Phil Spencer's thoughts on the PS5 reveal. After admitting in the email that Xbox lost the console wars in the last generation, Phil seemed really excited for the potential of the Series X and S. From the document, Phil seemed pretty confident that the new Xbox was the superior console, even going as far to say that they had a better product than Sony has, not just on the hardware, but equally important on the software platform and services on top of the hardware. So far, it seems that Sony is winning the console war again this generation, but the recent spike in Xbox sales due to Starfield might help turn the tide a bit. I don't know. Console wars are stupid, but I thought I'd share this anyway. At number 2, Microsoft tried to save their 2022. This is where those Bethesda remasters I mentioned earlier would have come in handy. Look, it's no secret that Xbox is lacking when it comes to exclusives. 2022 was particularly difficult for Xbox, as a lot of the games originally slated for that year were delayed, mostly due to COVID or other world events. Delays for Starfield, Redfall, and Stalker 2 sent the higher-ups at Xbox into a bit of a frenzy. In the email leaks, Phil Spencer is seen showing just how empty 2022 was looking for Xbox and Game Pass, and was looking for the team to start signing deals with third-party developers to try and salvage the year. Some games that were considered were the Dark Souls games to help make a push for Elden Ring sales on Xbox, Dying Light 2, Gotham Knights, Jedi Survivor, and, as I mentioned earlier, Baldur's Gate 3. Not all of these games released in 2022, but I think at least announcing that they would be launching on Game Pass definitely would have helped Microsoft's case. Unfortunately, 2022 ended up being pretty quiet for Xbox exclusives. Okay, let's wrap this thing up. At number 1, we got our very first hints at the next-gen Xbox. Based on the leaks, Microsoft is looking at a 2028 release window, which lines up with the lifetime of previous gaming generations. This is obviously quite a ways out there, and a lot could change between now and then, but the biggest takeaway from this next-gen Xbox is the addition of hybrid computing. Basically, some executives at Microsoft want to make the next Xbox a hybrid console that utilizes powerful hardware and cloud computing. According to the leaks, Microsoft believes that their cloud services will be powerful and efficient enough by 2028 to run hybrid games. They believe that by utilizing built-in hardware along with cloud computing, devs can create even more demanding games, despite the actual hardware limitations. It seems as though Xbox wants to also bring this technology to the handheld market, mentioning a new device that would be under $99 to really showcase the benefits of their xCloud service. It's really interesting stuff. According to this article from The Verge, Xbox has already experimented with this a bit with the new Microsoft Flight Simulator, in which parts of the world are streamed onto your Xbox via the cloud. The leak goes into even more detail and showcases a roadmap. In this map, Xbox is stating that they will need to start inking the deals now with AMD and other tech companies if they want this technology to be readily available and stable by 2028. If the roadmap is still accurate, they're hoping to finish the hardware design part of it by 2024 and sending out the first dev kits in 2027. Meanwhile, Xbox will begin working on their first-party hybrid cloud games as early as 2024, which, honestly, could be The Elder Scrolls 6 to align with the launch title for this new tech. Whether or not these plans have moved forward or been abandoned, we don't currently know. This next generation could be really interesting because now Sony has also had a peek at what Xbox is doing behind the curtains, so they could very well copy or try to one-up Xbox's new console. This FTC versus Microsoft trial has caused a ton of information that would normally never reach the average consumer come to light. It's pretty interesting to see how Microsoft communicates and how they manage their company behind the scenes. But I want to hear your guys' thoughts. What was the biggest leak for you? Do you want Microsoft to buy Activision? I'm curious to hear what you have to say. If you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. It means a lot. I appreciate you guys, as always, and I'll catch you on the next one.